Still no podcast.
Boy, howdy. I want one so bad.
Captain's log. Still no podcast.
Stardate 130.22. Okay.
Forest date. Captain's log. The log is floating down the river.
Well, you got to turn it on its side and read its rings.
He's
the trees keep the minutes.
It's a guy that got stuck on a log floating down the river. Technically, this makes me the captain, he says.
This is my captain's log.
And anytime you're the only person in a boat, according to maritime law, you're automatically the captain. Uh-oh. Wait a minute. Wait a gosh darn minute. I think, yeah. Oh, fuck.
What's going on?
I don't have the right... My microphone is wrong.
Yeah,
Do I sound echoey? It's going through my laptop mic. Oh, jeez.
Okay. Yeah, now that you mention it, it does sound a little... You want to start over? It's very early. We can totally start over.
I'm just going to pause it for a second and we'll sort it out. Yeah, so technically, anytime that you are the only person in a boat, you are the captain of that boat.
But what if you're only like first mate material and you know this about yourself?
Well, that's what we call a doomed voyage.
Yeah. I would suggest if you're that type, maybe don't have the life preserver just up on the wall. Go ahead and put that around yourself.
Yeah. That or just like tie like the cord of a iron to your foot.
Mm-hmm.
That way, if the plane goes down, you won't have to worry about commanding a ship afloat at sea.
Okay. Yeah,
just walk around the boat with your...
See, I'm trying to keep people from drowning here, and you're trying to...
I just don't want any amateurs captaining ships at sea.
Even if they're the only ones on it?
Yeah, even if it's an inflatable dinghy.
Yeah, for the sake of that boat soul, that man should drown.
What? Whoa, wait. You know, like on a big cruise ship?
Mm-hmm.
They have, like... pools and water slides and shit.
Yep.
If you take a tube out in the pool, are you the captain of that tube? You exist in another layer of maritime law inside of a ship that's on maritime law.
Double secret maritime law.
Yeah. You're a secret captain.
I think that you are correct in this. I don't see any way around it. I don't know if the rules are drawn up just in miniature.
Yeah, you go out there in a little inflatable tube, and then you just have a flat screen TV, and you're showing Major League Baseball without the express written consent.
Also, what happens?
No one can stop me.
I wonder if there is an order of succession that might include you if something were to happen to the captain of the Carnival cruise ship.
Oh, like, you know, murder.
I have my stripes and my colors. I mean, who else are you going to come to in your time of need?
What if you were out in the pool and you were like, they were like, come on, it's time to get out of the pool. And you were in the middle like, no, I need to speak to the captain about something. And they're like, come on, sir. And you're like, you have to get the captain out here. I'm not going to get out of the pool until the captain comes out. And then they get the captain, and he walks up, and blam! You blow the captain away from the middle of the pool on the cruise ship. Technically, they can't try you in their maritime court and throw you in the brig because you were
in double international waters.
You were in their international waters. And also because you were the highest ranking person within the ship, you're the new captain.
Yeah.
You take, you're like, oh, well, I was the captain within this captain's domain.
I'll answer to whatever court has jurisdiction over me, but I know that no one has jurisdiction over me here. So until we're into safe harbors and you can turn me in, you can believe me, I will not be spending the rest of my cruise in the brig. Mm-hmm. Be doing it in that big captain's chair.
I can guarantee you three things. Number one, I will answer to whatever authority at the time that we do find ourselves ashore. Number two, I will not be taking meetings with anyone in the pool who's asking for me. And number three, we will never be going ashore again. And those are the three things you can be sure of as long as I'm the captain of this here cruise ship.
Eventually, we're going to run out of fuel. And that's why order number one is we're building very long paddles. So let's get everything together.
We're going to need the
lash a bunch.
We're going to need
the regular paddles together.
Knock out these windows and put those oars out them.
Yeah.
Eventually they'll come up with the plot to tie a big balloon around my waist while I'm not paying attention and just send me up into the sky for the sky laws to deal with me.
Ooh. You don't want to fuck with the sky people.
The sky lords will get me.
Yeah. Oh. They want to grind your bones to make their bread, from what I hear.
Is that a thing you can make bread out of, really?
You have to try really hard.
I feel like it's got to be, I mean, it's gluten-free, so it's got that going for it.
I wonder what kind of ovens they have that can make bone bread rise.
Cloud ovens. They have a goose that lays golden eggs. So maybe they just use a little bit of bone meal. Just, you know, to make the flour go further. They're cutting it with bone, Englishman's bone powder.
Possibly. And maybe that's just a good way to stave off osteoporosis.
Mm. Englishman's bone powder. The only bone powder approved by the American Association of Osteopaths. Englishman's bone powder seems like a thing that you'd see like a recreation of a tin of on the wall at a Cracker Barrel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, that's why dog dudes used to be white.
Is because of Englishman's bone powder?
Well, I don't know about Englishman's, but they put bone powder in dog food. And so when dogs would poop and then it'd freeze and thaw out, all the bone powder would still be there.
Is that really what happened?
Yeah.
I do remember, you know,
those white dog dudes.
Yeah. Well, they wouldn't, some of them would go all white, but some of them would just be like a silver fox doo-doo. There'd just be a tinge of it around on the curl, you know?
not like a full Ted Danson, but kind of a tan France.
Yeah, like what the Just for Men, what they're trying to get you to, where you're trying to comb, it's just gray on the poo.
Yeah.
Like
you're the editor of a newspaper who's always yelling and chomping on a cigar. The temples and
mustache of that shit is gray.
Do you have an idea for a podcast?
I do. This one is called Dead, Not Done.
Okay.
And this is a podcast where we're going to take whatever celebrities have died of late. And because of the way name, image, and likeness has become such a hot button issue, and the way that I've seen them do, like Colonel Sanders and Tupac, to name but a few, once you are dead, if you are famous, your image is not done. And so this would be a podcast where we take whatever our new crop of people who aren't allowed to say no anymore and see how they're going to translate to the cartoon universe or the hologram universe.
Okay, or the podcast universe.
Yeah, we can today use them on too.
Dead Not Done, Howard Hessman, Dr. Johnny Fever himself, you know, from WKRP in Cincinnati and head of the class.
Okay, vague memory there.
He's,
but I mean, yeah, a lot of these older sitcoms that they still play on TV occasionally. I can't imagine that there are too many mashers left. I think Night Court's pretty much cleaned out, et cetera.
Oh, mashers.
That's what I call people who were in MASH.
I was thinking of a man.
I call people who were in The Big Bang Theory.
It's like grabbing bangers. A lady on the bottom on bangers the train. Okay. That's what I think of. You know. And then they hit them with their purse and call them a masher. poke him with their big hat pin.
What were mashers doing? Were they just
mashing those taters?
they weren't gently feeling the suppleness of the tater. They were mashing them.
They were doing the mash.
They took a big spoon out and just stuck it in there.
They were trying to put dimples in it so they could pour gravy and then pretend it's a volcano. What sort of things would we be trying to get these dead celebrities into?
Oh, well, in general, I mean, I think that they mostly use them to do commercials and appearances at places. But I was thinking of ways that we could jazz them up that they would not do in life. Mm. Like what kind of funny hat they could wear.
Yeah. Yeah. I guess like it'd have to be something that went along with who they were in life. Right. Like they did that Fred Astaire Dirt Devil commercial. And it was like the Dirt Devil is dancing around with Fred Astaire. And then they did that one that was Kurt Cobain. Like, hi, it's Kurt Cobain here for Remington. or they did the Colonel Sanders where he's breakdancing, yeah, as he was known. He was such a fan of, I mean, the whole hip hop culture, really. He was into breaking, graffiti, and turntables.
Mm-hmm.
He called those the three extra secret spices.
But
people are trying to recreate KFC in their food laboratories. We can only crack 8 spices. What are the other 3? And Colonel's like, I'll never tell. And then he's spinning around on his head. Spray paint going everywhere.
And then just pouring a whole bunch of salt on his chicken.
There's oregano, there's pepper, there's salt, there's rosemary, thyme. We forgot all these different, but there's 3 that we can't figure out. It's almost like they're not flavors, but elements. Elements of the street. I'm sorry, you were saying?
Oh, I was just trying to get a list of who's most recently died, and what I'm seeing is that this was not a real good week for celebrity deaths. So I'm going with last week. We got both Meatloaf and Louis Anderson, who I think that you could have be mascots for competing Meatloaf restaurants.
Oh, yeah. Did you see about Weber Grills?
No.
Last week, Weber Grills, on the day that Meatloaf died, their automatic email that sends people a new grill recipe every Wednesday, mm-hmm, said, grilled Meatloaf.
Well, that's one way you could take it. Dead, but not well done. You don't want to overcook Meatloaf on a Weber grill.
They just have an ad where they open up the grill. It's the Super Bowl ad. Open up the grill. There's a little CGI Meatloaf in a little bread pan. Just, he's got a you know, like a sponge on a stick, and he's just basting himself in barbecue sauce. And I would do anything for love, but I won't do that. And when it says, but I won't do that, it's just showing like an air fryer on someone's counter. No, 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 I won't do that. And it's the George Foreman grill.
Yeah, that's a good call, Dead Meatloaf. Now, in that music video, he made himself out as like the Beast and the Beauty and the Beast, where the Beast rides a motorcycle. But
that was a magical time.
Would make a really great mummy. I think that maybe we try to make mummies cool again and have Meatloaf help us out with that.
He's just yummy mummy in the monster cereals. They make a big press announcement. The cereal monsters are getting an update. Now, Yummy Mummy will be played by Meatloaf.
Which one do you think that Louis Anderson would fit? Do you think he'd be a good Frankenberry?
He seems more like a fruit brute to me.
I don't know. I've never seen Louis Anderson covered in hair. There's so much pink flesh there to...
Yeah. I guess maybe a Booberry.
Yeah, doesn't Booberry have like an old timey hat of some
sort?
He's
like, he has Yogi Bear's pork. I guess that's actually Art Carney's pork pie hat.
Mm-hmm.
But then he's got Lon Chaney's face.
Okay.
Or wait, not Lon Chaney. What's the guy with the sunken eyes? He's always on the Bugs Bunny too.
Oh, he's a German guy, isn't he? He's in Casablanca, but he's also in Fritz Lang's M. Oh, God, that's going to kill me. I can't think of his name. Peter Lorre. There we go.
Peter Lorre. There we go. And I'm sure that all of our 14-year-old listeners are... sitting there like, I'm so glad. So glad they got to the bottom of that. I was screaming at my podcast device. Peter Lorre.
But that makes me realize that this is not such a new thing, because there have been lots of little Peter Lorre cartoons running around for years after his death, and he probably kicked off in the 60s.
Yeah, I guess that's really where you go when you die, right? Then if you were just a kind of an oversized personality.
Mm-hmm. Well, now that Mel Blanc is dead, he's not there to steal your soul and make money off of you in perpetuity.
But it seems like a lot of cartoon character voices are just some guy who couldn't make it as a comedian doing voices, but he could do one celebrity's voice really well. So he's just going to do that voice, but give it to a cartoon panther or something.
Yeah, it's not exactly Peter Lorre, so it's okay that he sounds exactly like him.
Yeah, which is also interesting, because then I think that makes Jackie Gleason like the first dead person to do a commercial, because it was Fred Flintstone in the pool on the cruise ship of Jackie Gleason.
Mm-hmm.
Just smoking Winston cigarettes and hawking vitamins.
Yeah. Make sure to get the flip top box.
I guess though, Jackie Gleason did outlive the Winston cigarettes commercial, right? So that one doesn't count. Boy, that's wild. Jackie Gleason was alive, and the most popular cartoon was just someone doing a complete ripoff of his thing. That must have made him furious.
Did he get any? Yeah, he didn't get anything from the
Flintstones. I don't think they never said based on the Honeymooners. It's a shame that we couldn't have Jackie Gleason with us today, in a day and age where you can go back and sue someone's family.
Maybe that's how we do him honor, is we make a show about him suing Hanna-Barbera, taking all of their money. And then we just bury it all with him.
We write a legal thriller about Jackie Gleason, an alternate universe where Jackie Gleason is still with us and he's suing Hanna-Barbera. It's a bestseller.
But can our pen name be Nathan and AJ Grisham? Brother lawyer novelist.
Nathan and AJ Grisham. And then we have our little dust jacket picture, and it's the two of us in like Tweedledee and Tweedledum costumes slap fighting each other.
Yeah.
Nathan and AJ Grisham's dad had a lot of money, so they didn't have to work very hard. This is their book. All right, I have a second idea for a podcast.
Good, good.
This is called Riddle Me These.
Okay.
This would be a podcast about riddles. I don't know if you're aware of this. There's yet another Batman. The smoke coming from Warner Brothers Studio has turned white. They have chosen a new Batman. What's his name? The guy from Twilight. Robert Pattinson. Robert Pattinson. As the Robert Pattinson approaches the stream for water, he is ever vigilant, as the cheetah is nearby. Yes, Robert Pattinson is playing Batman, and Paul Dano is playing the Riddler. And there's a lot of talk about this Riddler character.
Mm-hmm. Mostly, and let's not sell him short. What's the Irish actor's name who will be playing the Penguin? Former heartthrob star of
Billy Connolly.
yeah, Billy Connolly.
He's not even Irish, goddammit.
No. It's, why can't I call Colin?
Farrell.
Yes, thank you.
Colin Quinn.
Colin Quinn will be playing the Penguin.
is it Colin Farrell?
Colin Penguin. Yeah, Colin Farrell is the Penguin.
Oh my god, I didn't know that. I knew about the Paul Dano thing because they keep showing, and he just looks like a character from the Venture Brothers.
Mm-hmm.
But he's clearly supposed to be like the Zodiac killer.
We got two low key Batman villains. They aren't doing the Joker again. They're not doing something. They're doing the stupid ones, and I like the stupid ones.
The stupid ones, honestly, the stupider the better. And they haven't gotten much stupid. The stupider would have been when they did Mr. Freeze with Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Mm-hmm.
And Poison Ivy, that was a weird one. It was like, okay, more people are familiar with the cartoon show now, I think. So they put Poison Ivy in there. And then Bane. Ooh, do you think we'll get to see another Mr. Freeze Batman movie? He could be like, they'll change his backstory to be that he was a climate scientist. Kept trying to warn people about climate change.
And then he just goes off his rocker and he's like, you won't be freezing your grandchildren. I'm going to freeze you.
Yeah, he's like an eco-terrorist. Holy shit.
And then it would make sense that him and Poison Ivy are hanging out, because that's exactly what she is.
Yeah, they're eco-terrorists.
And in a way where you're almost like, Batman's kind of the bad guy. I'm kind of with the eco-terrorists on this one.
Yeah, and then Bane, and he's from, South America. And they just, in the movie, they're like, he's a communist. And then Batman teams up to make us all think that eco-terrorism and communism are bad with his family fortune. Look, I don't know for sure if Bane is a communist, but they kind of made him seem like that in the last movie with Bane in it.
Yeah, but that was different than any Bane I'd ever seen. Usually I'm like, he likes to wear like a luchador mask. He likes big muscles and bigger trucks and motorcycles.
Yeah. And he's a big, tough guy.
Like, it seemed like there might have been, there was the venom that he takes. I think there might have been a cartel that he was ahead of that was distributing the venom. Like
I mean, he did kill a CIA guy.
Two South American stereotype, bad guy stereotypes.
Yeah. It is funny that, like, just imagine, like, a South American cartel, and then their bad guy, like, the leader of them in some drug movie, he's like, oh, hello. I'm so glad you've come to my cartel. So with Riddle Me These, I was thinking that we would just do, like, come up with our own riddle every week. And anybody solves it gets an Amazon gift card or whatever.
Okay. Will there be, like in a Batman, like, will there be consequences if they don't solve it in time? Will anybody die?
Yeah.
Like, so we will be setting up death traps as well.
Oh, yeah. Oh, of course. Are you kidding me? Of course we will.
But we'll still have an Amazon gift card because doing the right thing and saving a life isn't enough incentive. You also get an Amazon gift card.
That's right. We need to be setting a good example to these people who are solving our riddles. That's Riddle Me These.
Okay.
Do you got a? You got another one?
Yes. This one is called, you can pick your friends, but you can't pick your coworkers. And this would be a podcast where we're forced to tell one of our coworkers about our podcast and have them on as a guest.
Okay.
I mean, let's not pick this one. This one's okay. Terrifying.
But we can explore it a little bit.
Yeah, it's been in my list for a very long time, and I've always been like, ugh, no.
I feel like it could be enough to just do an episode where, if a coworker finds the show, then they'll see their name is the name of the episode and be like, oh, and they'll listen to it. And it's just us explaining ourselves to that coworker. Like, look, okay, I know that you probably Googled your own name and this was the only thing that came up. And you were like, wait a minute, is that Nate from work? He has a podcast and my name is the name of an episode. Yes. This is how you find out. But not because of anything you did.
Yeah. I'm not just trying to source the people for my riddle death traps for my work. It's not what's happening.
But now that you're here, I have placed a small explosive device behind the propane tank on your back deck grill. If you don't answer me these riddles three, well, it's like, how would he know? How would he know when I was going to discover his podcast? This is malarkey. Just turns it off before we can tell him about Blue Chew's amazing boner chewables.
And we blow the fuck out of his grill.
Hey, it's me, Fred Flintstone. Hey, do you have problems getting it up? Try my chewable Viagra. Blue Chew, if anybody who works for Blue Chew is out there listening, sponsor our show and I will do a different bad celebrity impersonation endorsing your product for the rest of my life. Or until AJ gets tired doing this podcast.
Oh.
Do you have a coworker who you think you could confide in that you have a podcast?
I do, and I have coworkers from former jobs who did know that I had a podcast and even listened to it occasionally.
I remember, at the current job,
there may be two people I could tell and not be too embarrassed and be like,
hey. You'd probably have to explain what a podcast was first.
Yeah, I did go from a job where I was one of the older people to a job where I am one of the younger people now. So I would maybe have to.
You have it easy where you could be like, oh, I'll tell him. And then he'd have to figure out how to download the podcast. I actually do have a younger coworker, basically my only real coworker, and they are a young person, and I often worry. They're savvy enough to figure it out.
I don't know. I wouldn't worry that much because I have found that I'm somewhat open. Like when people will be like, oh, what do you like to do? And I'll be, well, you know, drink myself into a stupor, watch movies. I do a podcast. Oh, you do a podcast in one ear and out the other.
Yeah.
You know, 19 you think, like, out of 20 people aren't ever going to follow through and look anything up.
What if my secret crush found out about my podcast and then they didn't listen to it just like everyone else I know? You know, I did one time, if you host a podcast on SoundCloud, it will show you the profiles of people who have listened to your podcast on SoundCloud. And there was some girl that I went on one Tinder date with and then never spoke to again who did listen to some podcast episodes that I was on. I was like, oh, well.
I guess it was a total loss then, that money I showed up for.
I guess I made an impression, huh?
Yeah. But anyway, this is a bad idea for podcasts because there could be good podcasts with this premise, but all the people I'd be most comfortable with asking wouldn't probably make for a good episode. Where the good episodes would be the most discomfort, the oldest, meanest, most racist person I work with or like, you know, it would be a fish out of water, possibly, sort of thing, too. Just the oldest person, and they don't know what's happening. But that wouldn't be the way I would go. I would go with the person probably most like myself, and we would get nothing new or good from it, probably.
What do you think is the record for the oldest person to be a guest on a podcast?
Oh, man.
Like you talked about like just an old incoherent rambling. I know that, didn't Mark Maron interview Carl Reiner?
I was thinking along the same lines. I was like, I think Mel Brooks has done some podcasts.
Yeah. I think that there was an episode of WTF. That where it was basically just elder abuse, like a very, very old Carl Reiner, like, oh, what? Oh, yeah, show business. Just like. And then Mark Maron's like, wow, that was amazing, wasn't it? Oh, my God.
Did they make him do a Blue Chew commercial?
He was doing Sherry's Berries, baby.
Oh, okay.
Is Carl Reiner dead?
I'm going to say yes.
We're going to get him on a Casper mattress commercial.
Is that going to be a rule? You're only doing the dead celebs for your impressions?
Yeah, you don't want to get that Jackie Gleason heat on you.
Okay.
I guarantee you Hanna-Barbera probably had to go through 3 or 4 different guys. Just kept getting their legs broke by Jackie's boys.
Do you think that they lucked out because he didn't realize that they were 2 last names? So he was looking for some goofy broad, this Hanna-Barbera.
Hey, you can't find her anywhere. Hanna-Barbera. What's she up to?
When I find her, woo-wee, straight to the moon.
God damn.
Well, do you have another podcast idea?
I do. This one I think is even less doable than the one with the coworkers or the one where we control dead celebrities. This is called Are You Smarter Than a Gladiator?
Ooh.
This is a game show where you compete with a gladiator, but you're answering, what is the capital of France?
Okay, that's Paris.
Not to the gladiator, though.
Oh,
he's gonna be like, the Goths control that.
Yeah, you're talking about Gaul? The capital of Gaul? Is
Gaul?
That silly place where Asterix and Obelix would keep us from taking it over and over again. So who would be right? Would there be a set of correct answers for me and a set of correct answers for the gladiator?
I get we could also just, cheap out and get this is the American version. You know how there's like,
yeah, we're gonna get British Nitro from the American Gladiators. Yeah,
we'll have Are You Smarter Than an American Gladiator?
So all of his answers will be from 1994. Which I believe Paris would be correct in both instances, but
yeah, but maybe they'll be like, who's the hottest chick in Hollywood?
His answer is probably going to be Pamela Anderson.
Oh, Halle Berry. And then we'll be like, Timothy Chalamet. another way we could go about this is to just do like a general poll of information about gladiators. And then that's where we set the bar for the questions. Like, did gladiators from ancient or American times know about this?
Okay. So, like,
do you know what dirt smells like?
I'm going to say they both do.
Yeah. But especially the gladiator from the movie Gladiator. He loved to smell dirt. You remember that? He'd get it in his hands and then he'd smell his hands.
It made him think about his farm before the Romans showed up and murdered his wife and child.
He said, I have a wife back home with hair as dark as the soil. Guy had a soil fetish.
Yeah. Do you think he would be into mud wrestling if he were an American gladiator? Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
Well, let's get him in the Bill and Ted time machine and bring him back here. And then we'll show him mud wrestling and see what happens.
Yeah. I mean, all figures throughout history, if they developed any sort of fetish, we could really do it up for them here in the future.
Hey, check it out. Are you not entertained? What are some other, there's Catherine the Great, I suppose. We could show her a good time. Mm-hmm. We do live in the horse racing capital of the world. You can't get any better than these, lady. That's Are You Smarter Than a Gladiator?
Okay.
All right, let's go to the Podtron. Folks, the Podtron 4500 is an artificial intelligence. We trained it using the podcast charts. It took the top 1,000 podcasts, and then it analyzed that information and spit it back out into a list of podcasts that we can use. Podcasts like this one, and again, I want to be very clear, we have a computer that's doing this, and we are not coming up with these ourselves and saying a computer came up with these ideas. Podcasts like Women Who Suck.
Okay. Now, what do you think the Podtron had in mind for this one?
Well, I mean, listen. There are a lot of fellas who suck too.
Yeah. What I mean is possibly the Podtron meant women who aren't very good that we wouldn't like. But it could also mean we're doing interviews with people in the porn industry.
Hey, don't act like people in the porn industry are the only ones sucking dick. There are plenty of Olympic grade people who just don't want to give up their amateur status to be in the Olympics.
That's true. There should be a sex Olympics.
Yeah. They don't want to go pro because then you can't go back and be in the Olympics.
Way back in the day, the Olympics was almost a sex Olympics. And then we've just been taking it farther and farther away from that. And it's
less and less sexy. No drugs.
Though, fuck the winter sex Olympics. That's no good.
Yeah. Nobody's shaving their legs.
You got to do everything on ice or snow.
It's
chapping and shrinkage.
They have that one thing in the Winter Olympics where you get to shoot a gun, though. I don't think there's any Summer Olympics where you can shoot a gun.
I think you are correct about that, but I think that they pair that shooting of the gun with cross-country skiing.
Yes.
That's skiing without a hill.
Yeah.
Just, it's grueling, and there's no adrenaline or fun to it.
If this were not in the Olympics, it would definitely be called a scoot and shoot. And you do it once a year at the local gun range to win a turkey.
Mm-hmm.
Women who suck.
Okay. So we're just, are we going to bag on the internet's least favorite people? Are we going to, is this going to be a, what did Lauren Boebert say this week?
I mean, we could just, it could be a history podcast.
Okay.
That way there's no one's going to be like, well, now I'm trying to think of a universally reviled woman. And maybe we should go with like a fictional woman just to make sure that we don't catch any flack. We could be like, you know, Cruella DeVil.
Yeah.
Oh, no, wait. No, that was the one last summer when that, they made the Cruella movie and then
they made her, tried to make her more less straight up and down evil. They did a Maleficent with her.
I just remember there was like a New York Times piece that was like Cruella DeVil is a feminist fantasy.
I say if you're going to make a movie focusing on Cruella DeVil, you change that character to not be a fashion icon to begin with. And just make it be about some weird person in backwoods Indiana who will kill 100 puppies to make a coat out of it. That coat looks awful. That's not a lot of fur that you're getting. It looks like a shitty quilt. There's that white fur has blood stains all over it already. And then she gets in her crazy jalopy and drives it like a maniac around town. And all the children tell freaky stories about her. That's a horror movie.
Yeah. Also very funny that the out of all of the Disney villains that they could have said were a feminist icon, they did pick the one that was like modeled after the head animator's ex-wife because he hated her so much. Or I think that is the lady from The Rescuers.
Yes, yeah, that's the...
But they recycled a lot of those animatics for Cruella DeVil.
Yeah, it was that period of Disney where they're like, oh boy, we're losing a lot of money. We're going to cut some corners, but there's some pretty good movies that came out of that, so...
Yeah. You're like, you watch Robin Hood and the Aristocats and Maid Marian and the Mom Cat from the Aristocats both do the exact same dance.
Mm-hmm.
To live in that time as a child must have felt like being a conspiracy theorist. You were like, they're doing the same dance. No one will listen to you. You're like,
yeah, especially because it
Gene was Hackman, an enemy of the state.
Before VHS or Betamax. So that you'd see it one or two times, and then like you'd have to remember that directly years later when they reused it.
Yes. That's women who suck. Is there one on this Podtron list that you like?
I don't know if I like it or not, but it's certainly stood out.
Okay.
It's called Orangutan and Prawn.
I did see this one as well. And I thought
I don't know if it's like one of those things where they're two animals and they're, you wouldn't expect them to be friends, but they're the best of friends. And watch this 3-minute video of them palling around and let it bring a little joy to your heart. Look at how the prawn swimming around in the water and trying to jump out, and the orangutan is taking his long finger and scratching the prawn's itch.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They're such good buds.
I can hardly believe it. These two guys, they get along so well.
Mm-hmm. Maybe this is a podcast where we try to find an odd coupling of animals that are just not compatible, where they wouldn't get along like an orangutan and a prawn.
Yeah. And is there a specific type of shrimp that's a prawn, or is it just another name for a shrimp?
Because
I know, like, they call everything a prawn in, like, Australia. But then, like,
yeah, there are different cuisines here, that it's like, it's always a shrimp or it's always a prawn. So I kind of like think prawn shrimp. The same thing.
But that could be, you know, a thing where they're like, you know, tiki masala chicken. And you know that one of those words must mean chicken, but you go along with it because what else are you going to do? Get harassed by this guy? He's going to start chanting, "Let's go, Brandon," at you because you said, "Excuse me, is one of those words mean chicken?" He's like, "If you don't like it, you can leave."
Going back to the coworker podcast, I had one of my coworkers try to give me a fun fact. Is they are aware that I like fun facts, and I'm usually the bringer of the fun fact. Okay. But he was trying to match me, and he said that don't you think it's weird that we got a word we call it beef and we call it pork, we don't call it pig and cow, but chicken's just chicken. And I was like, well, there's this word called poultry, and he goes, "That's not the same thing." And I'm like, pretty sure they're like all French. I think the French did that. Then he started insisting that it was the Swedes, and then I was like, "This is why I don't have coworkers on my podcast."
The Swedes, they control everything.
But maybe we get a zoologist on here, and we just find out like what are the animal pairings that haven't been tried, and we'll just see if they can be friends.
Yeah. I would be afraid that my coworker would come up to me and be like, "Hey, I hear you like trivia. I got a fun fact for you. You know, you ever eat a dog?" "No. You know who has? President Barack Obama."
Yeah. Yeah.
It's true, man. Look it up. Truthfacts.usa.ru.
He started with the face first.
That's orangutan and prawn.
Yeah.
I have another one here from the Podtron. It's called Waiting for a Podcast to Drop.
Mm-hmm.
And this would be, kind of a waiting for Godot situation. But it's
would
where
we
we're waiting
for our
podcast.
Own podcast to drop or one that we're just a fan of.
We'll you know, like, now that I say it, that's kind of what we're doing, is a waiting for Godot of our own podcast to drop.
It is.
We keep talking about it. When will it get here? Waiting for a... in my head, this is more like a sneakerhead, but for podcasts kind of podcast.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we talk about... Sometimes, you know, somebody will do a podcast, and before they actually podcast, they just post one to iTunes that's like a preview. I guess we did that, didn't we? With our... with our podcast about not having a podcast, we did do a preview just to get it out there on iTunes. Mm-hmm. But we could just talk about those.
Oh, ones that only have a preview. And we can do what we do on these episodes, and we can speculate on what these currently unproduced, undropped podcasts will be.
Mm-hmm. I guess we'd have to search for, like, coming soon. And then find ones that somebody has said is coming soon, but is not out yet. And then we, you know, we do the fanboy thing.
We try to scoop them. Yeah. We put an episode of their podcast out before they can.
Oh, my God. That's an even better idea.
While you're waiting for your episode to drop, maybe you'd like to listen to an episode of In the Style of that show.
It's like when you try and find a song on a streaming service and they don't have the song because the artist doesn't put their stuff on streaming, but then they have one that's like by the Birthday Crew, and you're like, oh, okay, yeah. I guess I'll listen to this.
We'll be like the asylum of podcasts. Like you can't wait for that new Transformers podcast. So we've got Transmorphers waiting for you.
Yeah. We got the Jonah Hill podcast by the Birthday Crew. That's waiting for a podcast to drop.
Okay.
You got another one here?
Yeah, this one, I don't think that this is a real podcast, but I did not do a lookup. It's called the Vivisectrix.
Ooh.
Which, had Orangutan and Prawn earlier, and so I was just, when there was another podcast idea that was about sewing two different animals together.
It is gendered. I don't think either one of us is qualified to be the Vivisectrix.
Well, what would be the masculine form of the
Vivisector?
Vivisector. Yeah, okay.
Yeah. I guess there's two of us, so it'd be the Vivisectries.
Mm-hmm. Well, I didn't want to do any vivisecting either.
Yeah.
Vivisector. We'll hire somebody to do it.
And then we'll call them the Vivisectory.
Yeah, okay. But, I've already pitched my hard R Cruella DeVil horror film.
Ooh, what?
My hard R Cruella DeVil horror film.
Oh.
Yeah.
Like the MPAA hard R, not the...
Yes.
In this movie, Cruella DeVil says it like a real Quentin Tarantino hard R.
No, I meant restricted is what I meant.
Yeah. Minors not allowed without a parent or guardian.
If that's a big hit, you know, maybe we're looking for other older properties to bring into modern times. And the island of Dr. Moreau, what if he were not an island? What if he was in a strip mall?
Mm-hmm,
there's all
mm-hmm.
these weird, like, half-monkey people that are going in and out of the strip mall. I work at the CC's Pizza next door, and we got a weird, weird lunch crowd.
The public access half hour of Dr. Moreau. He's just there at the public library's TV studio once a week. And he's got like a little tiny half man, half capuchin monkey. Do it. He's in a little chair next to him. It's a talk show.
Yeah. I want the plot of this movie. I don't want it to be a horror movie. I want it to be like all of these weird creatures are forming a dance crew to try to save Dr. Moreau.
He comes out. He's straightening his tie. Hey, give it up for our house band. the cat people.
Maybe they're the entertainment for CC's Pizza.
Have you heard about this one, Monkey Man? Have you seen this? They say that CC's Pizza, they're trying to resurrect a hologram of Pamela Anderson. Have you seen about this, Monkey Man? Have you seen this?
Oh, or maybe it's when Chuck E. Cheese's and Showbiz Pizzas first started, and they're gonna put the Moreau's pizza business out of business with their robots. Soulless robots.
Pizza theater.
People want vivisected monkey people to entertain them while they eat their shit pizza. I don't know, but I feel I apologize. Both of my choices from the Podtron list were flights of fancy that in no way are podcasts.
I mean, sometimes bad podcast ideas make good podcast ideas really shine.
That's true.
So here are our options, and may they shine bright. We have Dead Not Done, Riddle Me These, You Can Pick Your Friends, But You Can't Pick Your Coworkers, Are You Smarter Than a Gladiator, Women Who Suck, Orangutan and Prawn, Waiting for a Podcast to Drop, and The Vivisectrix.
Okay. I think I like Waiting for a Podcast to Drop the best. I could also do Dead Not Done or Riddle Me These.
Out of all of them, I think I like Dead Not Done the best, but I could also do Riddle Me These.
Maybe we do Dead Not Done and the new episode that's dropping. We're going to do an episode with a dead celebrity's name attached to it.
Okay. All right. We can do that. So folks, if you want to hear Dead Not Done and you'll have to wait and see who the dead celebrity is. But if you want to hear Dead Not Done with blank, go to our Patreon, patreon.com/we don't have a podcast yet. That's all one word. And sign up to support the show. We have over 100 podcasts that we recorded and then put behind a paywall to make you pay for them. And this week it'll be Dead Not Done. Thank you so much for listening. Please leave us a review. If you have an idea for a podcast, call into the podcast hotline at 702-PODCASP. We tried to get podcast, but it wasn't available. I'm Nathan P. Woodard.
I'm Andrew James Estes.
Good night.
Good night.